start. Let them join. One by one, students are joining. Okay, good morning, all. How are you all? All are good?
Yes,
Good
ma'am.
morning, ma'am.
Good morning. So after a long time, we are meeting. So congratulations. Without exam, you all have promoted to third semester. Happy, no? Very happy. Without exams, you have promoted. Any comments on this? You wanted exam or this is fine? Yes, Purthi?
Ma'am, to be honest, actually, we need exam, ma'am. This is like
Good,
we didn't
good.
learn anything, to be honest. Yeah,
Correct,
we
correct.
need exam. Yeah.
Correct. We don't know what they'll do because PTU has told they'll introduce one formula. Based on the formula, they'll give marks, something they are telling, but we don't know still what they'll decide. So, but anyway, all are promoted to third semester. It is good. So, see, students, some of the instructions, basic instructions I want to give about this semester. This semester, attendance is compulsory. All students have to attend classes. You should not tell any reason like you don't have laptop, you don't have internet connection. No, this time we are not going to listen any reason. If you have kept your laptop or left your laptop at your PG or in your hostel, now no lockdown, nothing, everything is open. You can come to your PG or your hostel and you can collect your laptops. And attendance is compulsory this time. Every day we are going to take attendance. Please don't give any reason to bunk class and to submit any assignments for any tests. Because last time we were not aware of the situation, so suddenly that happened. So even we were not mentally prepared, even the students were not mentally prepared. So that's why this happened. So this time we don't want to take any chance. So attendance is compulsory. All have to attend. And one more thing, in all the subjects it is there, but in my sub about my subject I'll talk. Every day we do the assessment. Assessment means just to check whether whatever I taught my students have understood or not. If it is a physical class, then by giving some assignment or by in the class only by asking one or two questions randomly, one or two students. So we would have done, we would have come to know whether students have understood or not. And if they have any doubt also, they would have come to us and they would have asked. But this online class, it is little difficult for all this. So that's why in all the classes, we are planning to do assessment. So the assessment may be in the beginning of the class or it may be in the middle of the class or it may be at the end of the class. So we don't know at what time we may conduct the assessment. And I want all students, all 53 students should attend this class. I don't want any students to bunk the class. And this, you know which subject I'm handling? Software testing.
Software testing.
Yes, this time I'm handling software testing. This subject is very simple. Very simple and very interesting. Yes, shall we start? Okay, students, first I'll give some introduction about my subject. Strength is very less. Out of 53 students, only 42 are there. I think in out of 42, I may be one participant. So only 41 students are there. Okay. Students, can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see the Word document?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the subject title is software testing, and the subject code is 18MCA 351. So in this subject, we are going to learn about. In this subject, we are going to learn about software testing. So this software testing has five modules. In the first module, we are going to learn the basics of software testing. And in the second module, the perspective on tech testing. And in the third module, boundary level, boundary value testing, equivalence class testing, and decision table based testing. Means the different types of testing you are going to learn in third module. Different types of testing, and in this module, some of the guidelines, observations you are going to learn. And in the fourth module, the path testing, data flow testing, and the level of testing, integration testing, we are going to learn. And in the last module, fault-based testing and plan and monitoring the process, documenting, analysis, and testing. So what it means is, in this subject, you'll get a complete knowledge of the software testing. Yes. So based on this syllabus, I have designed some of the course outcome. Students, you know what is course outcome? Anybody doesn't know what is course outcome? Please tell me if anybody doesn't know what is course outcome. Everybody knows? Please respond. Okay, if you know also, I'll repeat once again. See, course outcome means, so once after completing or after studying this subject, after learning this subject, what the student is able to do. See, software testing means the student will understand or learn the basics of software testing and how to write the test cases, And once he learn how to write the test cases with the types of testing, then whatever the problem I give to my students, they will be able to write the test case for all the scenarios. Yes, correct? No? If they are not able to write the test cases, then what is the use of learning the subject? So based on the syllabus, I have framed some of the, I have framed a few COs, course outcome of my subject. The course outcome is nothing but after learning this subject, what my students are able to do. So the first CO I have designed is acquire the knowledge of basic principles, and knowledge of software testing, debugging, and test cases. Yes. Once a student learn the subject, the student will get a basic knowledge. The student will acquire or gain the basic knowledge of software testing and how to debug and how to write the test cases. And the students will, CO2A, students will learn different types of testing to solve errors in an application. Yes, whatever the application we develop, so based on the test cases only, we are going to test our application. So by writing different types of test cases, the student will find the solution and try to debug errors of the given application. Write a different test cases for the given problem, or based on the scenario or based on the situation, whatever the problem you are going to, or whatever the application you are going to get, for that the students will be able to write different test cases. See, once you write the test case, next you should be able to implement the test case. If simply writing the test case and no implementation, then there is no use. Correct? No? The students will implement the test cases for the given application. And the fifth CO is apply the test cases for the current scenario. So current scenario, based on the current scenario, I may give you some of the projects or application or some of the problem statement. For that, you have to write the test cases and you need to apply. So these are all the 5 COs I have designed for my course. See students, at the end of this semester, you should answer for all these 5 COs. Whether you are able to, whether you acquired the knowledge of the software testing, whether you learned different types of test cases, whether you are able to write different types of test cases for a given problem, whether you are able to implement the test cases, whether you are able to apply the test cases for the current scenario or for the given application. So you have to answer for all the COs at the end of the semester. So understood what is your subject, what is the syllabus, and what are the course outcome of your subject? Hey students, please respond. If you don't respond, then I will not understand whether what am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, my voice is clear now.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So now I'll give you an example. Morning at 8 o'clock, you start from your home. Yes, students. Morning 8 o'clock, you start from your home. Your class starts at 8:30. Your class starts at 8:30, and from your home to your college, you need 15 minutes to reach from your home to college. You need 15 minutes. In between, what happens? You meet your friend. In between, you meet your friend and you start talking to your friend. You left your home at 8 o'clock. You know what is the time you need to reach your college, that is 15 minutes. Your class starts at 8:30. But what happened in between? You are meeting your friend. So you start talking after a long time. You have met your friend and you start talking. So you forget what is the time. So you are busy in talking. You're busy in talking. So after some time, you'll realize that you have class at 8:30. Yes, after some time, you'll realize that you have class at 8:30 and you tell your friend that I have class at 8:30, I have to go. Yes, then you will go. By the time you reach to your college, it will be 8:45. By the time you reach your college, it will be 8:45. So are you reaching your college or are you reaching your class on time? No. Why you are not reaching on time? You left home at 8 o'clock. The maximum time you need to reach your college is 15 minutes. But you met your friend and you started talking. There also you have not done any mistake. After a long time you met your friend and you started talking. Yes. You started talking to your friend and you forgot to check the time. What is the time? Now, what is the time? At 8:30, I have a class. Before 8:30, I have to reach to the college. But you didn't do that. And blindly you started talking to your friend. And when you realized you have class at 8:30, by the time you reach your college, it is already 8:45, you reached college or your class 15 minutes late. Yes, mistake has happened. Correct, no? See, it is common that everybody will do the mistake. When we talk, we do mistake. When we write, we do mistake. When we cook, we do mistake. When we walk, we do mistake. In the book, they have given an example. When we love, we do mistake, it seems. Is it so? Yes, students, when you are in love, then also you do a mistake, it seems. In the book only, they have given this example. It is a lighter part, I am telling. So when a student started home at 8 o'clock and he has reached college at 8:45. So in between, he has met his friend. He has met his friend and he started talking. He has not checked how much time he spoke to him while talking. He has not checked what is the time now. So that is the reason why he reached class 15 minutes late. If he would have checked after few minutes after started talking to his friends, his friend, after few minutes, if he would have tested, would have checked what is the time now, then he would have reached college on time. Yes, students, you are understanding now why I am giving this simple example? Yes, you are understanding now why I am giving this simple example?
Yes, ma'am.
Here, you have not done any mistake. You have not done any mistake from the beginning, but in between you have not tested something. In between you have not tested something. What is that something? What is that something? You have not checked the time. Now what is the time? You have not checked that. That is the reason why the output is you have reached the college late. You reached late. If you would have checked in between what is the time now, then you would have reached college on time. Why I am giving this simple example is the same thing when you apply for the software testing, when you apply for the software testing, when a developer develops some application, blindly we cannot, will not give the end user to use that application. Correct, no, students? We don't give application to the clients to use that application. First, we'll test. First, we will test the application. Then only we'll give the end user to use that application. So if you don't test, then what happens? If you don't test the application without testing the application, if you give the application to the end user, then what happens? What happens? You will get n number of errors. When the client start executing or start using your application without testing, if you give your application to them, then they may get n number of errors. See, it is common that all human beings make mistakes. It's common that all human beings make mistake, but we have to take care, we have to test whether whatever the application we have developed that is reaching the requirements of, that is reaching all the requirements of the customer or not. Whether it has any errors or not. Yes, the test engineer has to check all this. See, one simple example, when you cook rice at your home, before, if you keep it in the cooker, you will check the water quantity. Yes, check the water quantity, no? You will check the water quantity. Before you switch on the gas, you will check the water quantity, how much water you have put. Whether that much water is sufficient to cook that rice or not. We'll check, no, students? When we are checking the water level to cook a rice, then definitely we are going to test the application. Definitely we are going to test the application before we give to the end user. Before we give to the end user. Correct, no, students? This is the reason why we are going to learn software testing. Yes, you understood whatever I'm giving the example? If you're not understanding, you can tell me and you can, or else you can message in the chat box. Yes, students, you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Students, for your syllabus, for your syllabus, you have three prescribed books. So out of three prescribed book, one is this book, that is Foundation of Software Testing. Foundation of Software Testing, second edition. This is your prescribed book. So about PPT and notes, you don't worry about. At the end of each module, I'm going to send the PPT and notes of all the modules. So this book you have to refer. So this book you have to refer. This is very nice book. And you can see the screen, students. Can you see the PPT, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the author is Aditya P. Mathur. The prescribed book is Foundation of Software Testing, second edition. The author is Aditya P. Mathur, and the prescribed book is Foundation of Software Testing, second edition. So the module is, so as I told already, in this subject we have five modules. So out of five modules, first we will see the first module, that is Basics of Software Testing, Basic Principle, Test Case, Test Case Selection and Accuracy. This we are going to learn in module one. So for this, to learn the module one, we need some of the, or we should have some of the knowledge of some of the knowledge we should have, that we call as a learning objectives, that is errors. See, what is error? What is error? When we write some program, sometimes we may write a program without any errors. Many a time we write program with errors. Some, it may be syntax error, it may be a logical error. So here we'll learn errors testing. So once you get a error, how you will come to know your program has error? How you will come to know your program has error? When you test your program, then only you will come to know your program has error. Then the debugging, how to debug, test process, CGF, you'll understand later. What is CFG, you'll understand later. Correctness, reliability, oracles, finite state machines, and the testing techniques. See, these are all the learning objective of this module one. So here the first thing is we are going to learn human error and testing. So who makes error? Students, who makes error? Who makes error? Please respond. All are attentive now. All are listening.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, who makes error?
Human beings.
Human being, exactly. And even the machine also makes error, but not all the time. But every time what the machine does, whatever the instructions we are going to feed to the system, those instructions only the machine is going to execute. So who are going to feed those instructions? Human. Yes, correct, no? The human is going to feed those instructions in the machine. So if human make errors, then definitely the machine also do the error. So here the human makes error. So how we'll come to know whether we have done error or not? How we'll come to know? we have done error or not. Error is nothing but you can assume whether a mistake. How we'll come to know whether we have done any mistake or not? When we are not getting a desired output, then we'll come to know the human has done some error. Yes, students, if you add, I'll give simple example. If you want to add two numbers, using a formula C is equal to A plus B, using this formula, we are going to get the output. If this statement is correct, without any error, then definitely the output, what we are going to get is whatever the desired output we have, we should get that desired output we are going to get now. If to find the sum of two numbers, if I give C is equal to A minus B, then the output, the desired output is not whatever the output is not getting whatever based on my requirement. Correct? No? Students, please respond.
Yes, ma'am.
So then we'll come to know the human has done some mistake. So we have to So some error is there in the program. So we need to test. Then based on that, if you debug that error, and if you change your code, then finally you will get a desired output. So now in detail we'll see error. So what is errors? Errors are part of our daily life. Correct? No? Errors are part of our daily life. Human makes error in their thoughts, action. In the product. Yes. Students, you are understanding?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please respond.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, errors are part of our daily life. When we think, see, whatever the thinking we do, we may not say that is correct. In the thinking also, we do some mistake. And in action also, we do some mistake. Yes, in action, when you are acting in any drama or when you are acting somewhere, then there also you may do some mistake. It's not only this thought or action. When you cook something, when you write something, so that time also you may do mistake. So errors occur whenever human are involved in taking actions and making decision. Yes, errors occur when a person or when a human is involved in taking actions and making a decision. Yes, the meaning is wherever the human is involved, there a mistakes happen or the error happens. These are all common things the human will do the errors or mistakes. Here one example is there in the error. See, hearing error. Sometimes I may tell that the speaking error, he has a garage for repairing foreign cars. Yes, students, the statement I'm speaking, that is, he has a garage for repairing foreign cars. But a listener may listen like this. He has a garage for repairing failing cars. Yes. getting the speaker, what he is speaking is he has a garage for repairing foreign cars, but the listener is listening he has a garage for repairing failing cars. Here what the mistake is happening? The hearing mistake is happening, the hearing error is happening. Correct? No? Yes, students, you are understanding? See, here some of the examples are there, some of the examples how the human make error or how the error happen. The error may happen in hearing, the error may happen in sports, the error may happen in writing, the error may happen in observing, the error may happen in medicine field also, and the error may happen in music performance, and the error may happen in analysis also. So one example is when a speaker is telling he has a garage for repairing foreign car, and the listener, what the listener is listening, he has a garage for repairing failing cars. Instead of foreign, here he is listening failing. So there the listening error is there, and the error may be in medicine, incorrect antibiotic prescribed. Maybe the patient has less immunity power. The doctor, instead of giving the antibiotic for the immunity power, he might have give the antibiotic for some other thing. So there also mistakes may happen. So music performance error. So incorrect notes. In the incorrect note, a singer may perform or the singer may sing the song. So incorrect note may play, and numerical analysis, incorrect algorithm for the matrix inversion. So how we do the analysis? With the help of a matrix we do the analysis. If any of the value or if any of the information present in the matrix, if that is wrong, then even our analysis may go. Is that if the matrix is wrong, then even the analysis will also be wrong. There may be a error in the observation. See, we may observation means we are seeing, by seeing only we'll come to know, that is nothing but a observation. We may think that, one example I'll give, in your test room maybe your friend asks you eraser or pencil or pen, something they ask. Then see, I'm observing both the students and I think that they both are cheating, but the actual reason why they both are talking means they need some help. That's the other student may need eraser or pencil. See, the mistake is happening in the observation also. And the mistake in software. When you write a wrong expression, then the error may happen. And error in speech. Nowadays, many. Education. Generally, what you say, education. Sometime, nowadays, many people, what they are telling, education. Education, they are telling, and situation. We tell situation, but nowadays, many people, what they are telling, situation. Correct, no? If I know the meaning of situation and situation both are same, then I don't feel there is an error. If a person doesn't know both are same, then that person feels there is an error. And sports area, maybe whatever the instruction the coach is giving to his students in tennis or in cricket, whatever the instruction they are giving, if they are not following properly, then the mistake has happened, and mistake will happen. And the writing generally, spelling mistakes we do. The right statement is What kind of pens did you use? And the wrong statement is, what kind of pants did you use? See, both looks same. Both statements look same. You can see the example, no? Yes, students, you can see this last line. What kind of pens did you use? And the wrong statement, I mean, by mistake, I may think like this. What kind of pants did you use? See, these are the some of the examples which may occur, or some of the errors which may occur in our daily life. Like the error may happen in listening, the error may happen in speech, the error may happen in writing, and the error may happen in sports. Yes, students, understood? So this is a flowchart. This is a flowchart for error, faults, and failures. This is a flowchart for error, fault, and failures. See, students, you take down this diagram now. You are able to see the diagram. Yes, you are able to see the diagram.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. See here, the programmer. The fields I'll read out. First, I'll read out the fields. Programmer writes program, produce observable behavior, leads to observation. Then are the same. See, this field is are the same. Next, coming to this specification, errors, fault, and here also again we have desired observation. Yes, students, you got any idea by seeing this flowchart? You got any idea by seeing this flowchart? Any answer? Yes, any answer? See, just now explained you about errors. In everyday life, we do mistake. The mistake may happen in speech. The mistake may happen in speech, behavior, observation, sports, speech. Means in everyday life, we may do some of the errors or mistakes. So based on that, you explain me, you tell me how this flowchart is.